You can access the business zone via the orange customer zone. Click Analyze Invoices and Usage in the Invoices and Usage section in the orange customer zone. If you don't have access to business zone yet, just ask your account manager or contact your customer support team. Once you're inside, you can start organizing your company's structure by creating departments, cost centers, or other organizational units. To set up your hierarchy, click the Setup tab in the top navigation and choose Set Hierarchy. Click Tree Builder to get started. On the left side of your screen, you can select the level in which you want to create a hierarchy structure. Fill in the names of your structure, for example, departments, cost centers, or other organizational structures here on the right side of the screen. Then click Add Notes. Now it's time to assign billing accounts to organizational units. In order to link phone numbers to your organizational units, you first have to link your various orange invoice accounts to your hierarchy. Click View Accounts to see the invoice codes you can link to your hierarchy. Select the invoice code you would like to link to a specific level within your hierarchy. Click the Move Accounts button and select the destination hierarchy using the drop-down menu in the next screen. Click OK to save your company structure. Perfect! Let's move on to user management. Here, the first step is to link lines to users. There are two ways to add names to the various phone numbers in your fleet. You can import multiple descriptions at once by uploading an Excel document you've saved as a CSV file, or you can do it manually, one by one. If you'd like to use an Excel document, go to Setup, click on Descriptions, and choose Phone Numbers. On the next screen, click Import Descriptions. Here, you can upload an Excel document, like the example we're showing you now. In column A, we've put the telephone number, comma, description 1, comma, description 2. Save the document as a CSV file before uploading it, importing the descriptions and clicking OK. If you prefer adding your descriptions manually, one by one, click Add Phone Numbers. Here, you can fill in the phone numbers, description 1 and description 2 manually and click Save to save your changes. The next and final step in managing the user information is assigning your services to departments or cost centers within the organizational structure. Navigate to Setup, click Hierarchies, then Tree Builder, and choose View Services. Select the numbers you want to move and click Move Services. Select the hierarchy item you want to link your numbers to and click OK to save the changes. Once your users are managed properly, you're ready to move on to the reporting. The Business Zone features multiple reporting functionalities to check invoices and find other useful data. As soon as you access the Business Zone, you'll see a standard dashboard on the homepage showing you how much your last invoice was and how it compares to previous months. You'll also see your top users, how much you've spent out of bundle, and much more. Of course, you can always drill down to get more specific data. For example, if you want to know why your biggest user racked up so many out-of-bundle costs, the data you need is just a few clicks away. To check your invoices, select the Statements tab in the top navigation. Then click on the invoice for more details. You can expand the statement further by ticking the checkbox. There are two kinds of standard reports you can pull up: detailed and summary reports. You can find both of them by hovering over the Reports tab. For example, if you'd like to see the detailed report, Charges per Subscriber, just select it in the Detailed Report list. Would you like to export a report for offline use? No problem. Just click on the Export button, select the file format, and click OK. Summary reports can be displayed as a graph by clicking the graph icon above the table. These graphs can easily be exported as an image, like this. So far, we've only explored the basic features of the Business Zone. Now let's dive into the advanced version and see the custom features you'll find there. In the advanced version of the Business Zone, you have the ability to create your own custom reports. Simply click on the Add Report button and choose whether you'd like to create a report from scratch or based on an existing report. Click Continue, fill in the name of your report, and choose how you'd like to group the data, what kinds of fields you prefer to be displayed, and so on. When you're happy with the report, simply click Save. Automation can be very convenient when it comes to reporting. That's why you can easily schedule reports and have them emailed automatically to different stakeholders, even if they don't have access to the business zone. To schedule a report, just click on the calendar icon in the report overview and then indicate when you would like to receive a report and to whom it needs to be sent. Once you click Submit Order, we'll take care of the rest. To make sure your reports focus on the right information, you can apply specific filters. In the Standard Business Zone, you have a set of standard filters available. Very useful if, for example, you only want your reports to show details on data usage. In the Advanced version of the Business Zone, you have the ability to create filters yourself. Go to the Setup tab, then go to the Tools section and click Filters to create the filters you'd like in your various reports. You can either create a filter from scratch or create one based on an existing filter. There are plenty of possibilities, like, for example, creating a filter to see only costs linked to your Shape subscriptions. Access to the advanced version is available at a monthly fee. Interested? Check in with your sales or support contact at Orange today. This introduction to the Orange Business Zone is almost over. But of course, there is plenty of information to discover about the specific functionalities on the Business Zone pages. On each page, you'll find a question mark on the right. See? Right there. Just click it to find out more about the functionalities available on this page. If you still have questions or issues with the Orange Business Zone, our support teams are here to help. Thank you for watching this quick start guide. And we hope to welcome you soon in the Business Zone.